Hello friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix. Today I will show you how to install Windows 11 on this beautiful iMac that I have here. It's iMac with M1 processor. It will work on MacBook Pro, it will work on iMac and every iOS computers, okay? Okay, as I told you, I will install today Windows 11 on this iMac that I have here. The very first thing that I have to talk to you guys for the moment, if you just search on Google and say that, does this M processor support Windows? Then you will see a lot of answers here. Bootcamp, it's not supported on M1 and M2 processors on Mac computers, okay? With Apple Silicon. Bootcamp works only on Intel-based Macs. So let me say that if you have a Mac in 2019, it will work. You will install Windows 10 or 11 with Bootcamp, okay? But in Intel-based processors. With M1 or M2 processors, there is no Bootcamp. Let me show you here on settings. If you go here on settings and search for Bootcamp, then it's missing, okay? You see that Bootcamp is missing. This means that Bootcamp is not supported on M1 processors. But the good news is that we have some more options to install and use Windows in M1 processors. But unfortunately, there is no way for the moment to install Windows 11 on M1 processors on boot mode, okay? To reboot the Mac and boot on Windows. But we can install Windows 11 on a virtual machine and it works well. Two methods for the moment, okay? If we go here on official website and then you will see run Windows on a Mac using parallel desktop for Mac. But you see the option here, buy now. I know that you don't want to expend money or something and you want it for free. I'm here to show you how to install and use it for free, okay? But let me explain a little bit. You can download as a free trial and try, but you have to pay. Let me see my Mac here. And mine is 8 GB RAM, so 100 bucks is good for me. And I'm running the latest version of Monterey. Okay, so what I gotta do? I don't have to install Parallels today. I have something better for you guys. So let's use this amazing software. It's for free and it's called UTM, okay? Virtualizer. If we try to get this on a Mac App Store, then it will be not free. You have to pay $10, okay? The good thing of this is that you pay $10 and you can update automatically without trying to reinstall and install manually, okay? This is the good thing for this. No worries, you can use it for free. Let's go back here. And you can download it here, and then here it is, UTM, and we can install it and use it for free, and just download and install. I will show you right now. With this software, we are able to install Windows 11 on ARM processors, okay? So let me show you how right now. Just, I will open up, I will double click here. I wanted to install this UTM software, and let's see how it will work. We have this welcome to UTM. Well, okay. So what we gotta do? We have to create a new machine. Create a new virtual machine, browse UTM gallery, and we will go there real quick. User guide and support, okay? And this is the reason why I did this video tutorial, just to help you do it real quick, and maybe you don't have time to read all that guide, then I'm here to help you, okay? Here on the gallery, we are able to download Windows 11 ARM 64, okay, and this Windows 11 for ARM 64 processors is still in production, and we have to download this from Windows Insider program, okay. It's not public, okay. This guide is designed to work with Apple Silicon Macs. Let's click here, Windows for ARM, and then we will be here redirected directly on Microsoft Insider program to download. This is the page you need to be a member. Okay, and then let's be a member now. Okay, go here on Meet the Windows Insider program. Click Register. We have here Register for the Windows Insider. Sign in right now. And then what I gotta do, I have to create one. And I will use here Tips to Fix. Tips to Fix at Gmail. I will verify the email address. register for the Windows Insider program, I accept, and then just click register here. Flight now. So now we are registering on Windows Insider program. I will go back here on the gallery, click here again, and Windows for ARM processors. And then here it is. I'm redirected directly on this page. I will put this link on the description or in my website. If you don't want to create an account on Windows Insider program, then I will put this ISO file on my website, then you will download it directly without creating any account. So let's continue right now. I have to download beta channel, dev channel, okay? But I wanted to have this beta channel. It's cool, it's more stable, okay? Windows 11 client, ARM Insider preview, beta channel, okay? And then I will click confirm here. I will choose the language. I just confirm this beta channel and then click the language confirmation. You will be able to download now the ISO file. Okay, I will download it right now. And this is Windows 11 client for ARM processors M1 or M2. We are waiting for the stable version for ARM processors to be ready. And this one is 9.6 gigabyte, okay? I'm downloading here with full speed and it needs just 5 minutes for me to download. So we download the ISO, so we are here and ready to create a machine, create new virtual machine. Then just click here, virtualize, choose Windows here, VHDX image, make sure to check this, not uncheck, but keep it as it is. Check import VHDX image. And you can download it directly here if you wanted to click, and then you will be able to download it like I did before, but you have to register on Insider program. If you don't want to register and you want to download the file directly, just go in my website and download this ISO file. I will upload it on the website. Okay, another thing that we have to do is click here, browse. You see that browse? Go on desktop and choose this setup. Choose this VHDX image file that we downloaded from Microsoft. For the best Windows experience, make sure to download and install the latest spice tools for Windows drivers. Okay, here it is. Just make sure to download it. And let's have it here. Yeah, look at this. I just download spice guest tools that we need to install Windows drivers. Are really important. It's not that much gigabyte. Okay, I will keep it here on a desktop. And now let's continue. Then we'll click continue here. I have to choose default here on the CPU cores on this virtual machine. I will click continue. And then what I have to do, I will create here shared directory because we can share files between Windows and Mac. And I will keep it here on desktop because I like to paste and open, I like to create files on Windows, and then I need those files to access here on Mac, okay? Then I will click continue here, and then Windows, call, just put the name here, Windows 11, and everything else is by default. If you want to change this RAM, or if you want to change storage here, then click here, open, then click save here for disk image. And then now we are ready here. And then as you see, we are ready here to use it and install Windows 11. And all of this is for free, guys. Okay, we are ready. So what we have to do now, if you want to change the settings, here are the settings. And if you like to change the system, or you wanted to put some CPU cores more, or leave it as it is default, or you can change it, and we can change it later if you want, but you can try. I will leave it as it is. Display, full graphic inputs, you can change the settings here. Yes, I like to use this USB 3.0 network. It will use the same network. And we have here NVMe drive, leave it as it is. New drive, if you want to create a new drive, you can create it, and then I will click cancel here. Just click run here, and then you will see this pop up, start boot options. We see that this virtual machine is restarted. Now, just a moment.
Oh, okay.
Cool.
Here it is, Windows 11. Then click yes here. If you want to get mouse back on Apple now, you have to click Control and Option in the same time, and then you will see mouse here, okay? Control and Option in the same time.
So what we have to do to get the keyboard working on during the setup of Windows 11, and just go back here and stay on this window, and now you can click Next here, but now it will ask you to set up the keyboard right, okay? Before we go in that step, you have to click FN and Shift, hold it together on your keyboard right now. Here it is. You have to click here FN and Shift, both together. And then I will click here F10. Look at this. You will see this pop up right now. And click yes, because I need to have this window. It's really important for me, okay? And before we continue, we have to disable and bypass the network problem. Let me see the command. Here it is. We have to type here now this command. I will copy and paste, and I will just type it here on CMD. Maybe copy and paste is not working here, but I just have to type OOBE / bypass NRO NRO and then click enter, and then it bypassed automatically. It will restart the virtual machine, and then we will continue to set up the Windows 11. Okay, we don't have a lot of time to wait. So guys, what we got to do next? We have to install drivers. It's very important, but step by step. Here it is. Just a moment. Okay. Okay, here we are. Click next. I'll click yes here. I'll skip this. I don't have internet. Okay, here it is. Now continue with limited setup. I don't need to use internet for the moment. Accept. Put the name here and click next. I don't have to use password. I don't have to share my location. We'll turn all of this off. Okay. And then the next thing that we have to do is we have to install all the drivers that we have here on the Spice Guest, okay? We'll show you right now how to do it. You will see here this small icon here at the top, this disk, go here on that DVD. I will click eject if you want. I will click here CD, change. Then we'll go in desktop. Choose this ISO file and click open. Okay, here we are. We are here almost there on Windows 11. Install new build Windows now, not for the moment. Here it is. So let's install the drivers right now, because we need to see different view here. We don't have the full quality. So go here on the CD drive. I have to double click and Spice Guest tools. Let's install all the drivers. We need to install the drivers. Click next and agree. And let's see if this method will work.
And let's click here, restarting. We have these two updates. But this is working well. And it's evaluation copy. Let's see here on the system. We'll go here on the way down. So, okay, guys, thank you for watching this video tutorial. This is how you can install Windows 11 on M1 processor. Yes, sure, it's a virtual machine. You can use it here for your needs. Do not expect a lot for the moment because we still are on the beta version. We are not on the stable release from Windows 11 on ARM processors. We don't have Bootcamp yet from Apple, so it's not officially. So this method is free and it works. So you can use it and let me know what you think, okay? So thank you guys for watching this video tutorial. God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.